No idea where to start when it comes to your AP Environmental Science review? Then stay tuned, because in this video, we're gonna go over 15 tips that you can start using to start studying at home, as well as tackle the multiple choice and free response sections of the test. Before we get started, this video is brought to you by Albert. If you haven't already created your free account to start practicing for your APES exam, be sure to do so using the link in the video description below. Without further ado though, let's jump into these study tips. First, let's jump into 5 study tips that you can start doing at home for your AP Environmental Science exam. The first tip we have for you is to make sure that you are practicing, practicing, and practicing. The easiest way for you to score well on your AP Environmental Science exam is to simply expose yourself to a lot of practice. If you're looking for a free start, the College Board's Course and Exam Description Guide to AP Environmental Science has a practice test that you can work through. You may also find it helpful to get an online resource like Albert or to access College Board's past FRQs to see how past students responded to the free responses. The second tip we have for you is to make and study with flashcards. AP Environmental Science is a course that is incredibly vocabulary intensive, so it can be super helpful for you to create some flashcards and use them throughout the course of a school year. There are a ton of pre-made lists out there, so if you're looking for some good ones, we link to some in the blog article in the link in the video description below. Mathematical units such as meters per second are also super important to get right on your FRQ section, so if you need extra help in reviewing those sorts of resources, we also link to a helpful resource in the video description below. In the case where you don't like paper flashcards, you might find it helpful to find some virtual flashcards from sites like Quizlet. Tip 3 when it comes to AP Environmental Science general study tips is to make sure that you are taking your class and homework seriously over the course of a school year. This sounds super simple, but here's why it's important to you. When it comes to the free response section, it's going to become a lot easier to respond to the questions being asked of you if you can draw in classroom examples that you learned. So this means that if you're focusing on your assignments over the course of a school year, you're going to have a better understanding of the core concepts that will be tested of you on exam day. Also, if you don't fully understand something the first time around, you'll have the benefit of your teacher there to support you. Our fourth general AP Environmental Science study tip is to read environmental news. This may seem a little strange, but the reason why this is helpful is because it helps you connect what you're learning in class to the real world. So by checking out news sources like the New York Times or Science News, you're going to be able to understand how the concepts and principles that you're learning in class relate to what actually happens in the real world. This again makes it a stronger connection for you when you are then assessed on this particular concept come test day. Our fifth general APES tip is to think about how what you learned connects to the big four. So whenever you finish studying a topic or unit, try to think about how it connects to one or two of the big ideas. For example, in Unit 1, one of the main big ideas is energy transformation. So as you study geochemical cycles, you're going to want to be able to articulate the following: how energy is moved in each cycle and how energy is transferred in every step. If you can articulate these two things when it comes to each cycle, then you'll definitely be able to nail any geochemical cycle question on your exam. Remember the big four ideas. Idea 1, energy transfer. Energy is neither created nor destroyed, always transferred. Big idea 2, interactions between systems. Systems change when they interact. Big idea 3, interactions between different species environments. This simply refers to the idea that humans impact the Earth. Big idea 4, sustainability. To survive, humans need sustainable systems. Before we jump into some multiple choice tips, if you're finding this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. Also, consider subscribing for more AP review content like this. Now that we've tackled some general AP Environmental Science tips, let's jump into multiple choice tips. The first tip for you is to make sure that you're always fully reading the question first before you respond to the question. It can be super easy to get distracted by diagrams, data presentations, or text, and not focus on the actual question that's being asked of you. You only have a little over a minute to answer every single question, so it's important for you to hone in on what's being asked of you so that you can actually answer that question. Our second tip when it comes to the multiple choice section is to know population dynamics. This is a concept that is frequently tested when it comes to the AP Environmental Science exam, and now that you have the ability to use a calculator on your APES exam, you're going to be able to answer these questions even faster as long as you remember these two formulas. The first one is the rule of 70, which is a calculation to figure out the amount of time that it takes for a population to double in size. The easiest way to figure this out is that the doubling rate equals 70 divided by the population's growth rate. The second important calculation is the population growth rate. This simply tells you how fast a population is growing or contracting. Population growth rate is just a percent change formula. So it's the number of deaths subtracted by the number of births divided by the total population size. Tip three when it comes to the multiple choice section is to make sure that you're practicing your pacing. You're gonna have 90 minutes to answer 80 questions. This puts you at about a pace of a minute and 12 seconds per question. So if a question is taking you way too long, it is better for you to circle that question and come back to it and move on than it is for you to continue to invest a lot of time in an individual question. That leads us naturally to tip number four, which is to make sure that you are answering every single question when it comes to the multiple choice section of your AP Environmental Science exam. The reason why is because there is no guessing penalty. So it is better for you to make sure that you have an answer for every single multiple choice question than it is for you to leave 10 or 15 questions blank simply because you ran out of time. Tip five is to prioritize your study time on the heavily weighted topics related to the APES multiple choice section. There are three units that are frequently tested way more often than other units when it comes to your APES exam. The three topics that appear more on the exam are from Unit 9, Unit 3, and Unit 4. Those correspond with global change, populations, and Earth systems and resources. If you're watching this video with not too much study time left, focus on these three units. It'll pay you bigger dividends than focusing on other areas. Before we head into the five tips to tackling your APES FRQs, if you're finding this video helpful, do us a favor and hit that like button below. By doing so, you'll help this video get discovered by more AP Environmental students like yourself. Now let's wrap things up with five helpful FRQ tips for your AP Environmental exam. The first one is to make sure that you know the free response format and what your strengths are. The College Board does us a little favor by telling us exactly what order questions will be presented to us in. For example, question number one is always going to ask us to design an investigation. Questions two and three will ask you to analyze an environmental problem and propose a solution. Tip two is to practice reading and writing common and novel data presentations. The AP Environmental Science exam is full of diagrams and data presentations. So it's really important that you understand how to read a title, read axes, and the data points that are being presented to you. You're often going to see things like energy pyramids and food chains. If you're looking for more of these commonly assessed diagrams, there are helpful Pinterest boards that break these down if you want to just search for those on Google. This actually connects to our earlier tip on reading environmental news, because when you read environmental news, you'll also start to see more diagrams there. And from there, you'll be able to understand what's being presented of you and be able to summarize the key takeaways from the data that's being presented of you. The big thing to remember here is to always focus on being able to summarize the one or two important things from the data or data presentation that's being shown to you. Tip three is to make sure that you're understanding the task verbs and what they're asking of you. The College Board always uses these sorts of task verbs when it comes to the AP Environmental Science free response section. You're going to be asked to do things like calculate, describe, explain, identify, justify, make a claim, and propose a solution. When you're asked to calculate something, you're going to be asked to do a mathematical operation and show the steps that you took to get to your final answer. When describing something, you're going to want to talk about different characteristics of the thing that's being asked of you. When explaining things, it's all about talking about the how and the why something happens. With questions like these, you'll be referencing relationships, questions, processes, and different situations. Identifying things is super straightforward. You simply have to indicate that you know what is being asked of you and you don't have to provide a further explanation. Justifying things is all about supporting or defending some sort of claim or perspective in response to a question. Making a claim is to make an assertion based on evidence or knowledge. And finally, proposing a solution is to come up with something that solves the problem based on the evidence or knowledge that you have. Tip four is that the scoring guidelines are often like answer keys, so it can be helpful for you to use them a lot. Reference these past scoring guidelines to understand what's going to be assessed of you when it comes to your respective AP Environmental Science exam. The questions may be different, but the targeted skills will often be the same. You can use online resources like Albert for extra free response help as well. As you work your way through some of these scoring guidelines, here are some things to keep in mind. You're going to want to take note of how the graders only grade the first things that they read. So if the question asks you to list 3 supports and you list 10, the grader's only going to grade your first 3 responses. You're also going to want to take note as to how specific answers have to be and how vocabulary is scored. As you work your way through more scoring guidelines, you'll start to notice how each part is graded independently. That means that you might get part A wrong, but you're still able to score points on parts B, C, and D. Lastly, as you work your way through these scoring guidelines, make sure that you can clearly articulate why you got a particular question right or wrong. It's only by being able to explain why you got a particular question wrong and how that has changed your understanding of the core topic that you'll be able to improve on your AP Environmental Science free response section. Our 5th tip is to create a formula sheet and practice showing your work clearly. It's really important that you show your work clearly so that you can score full points on your free response. There are some helpful YouTube videos that do breakdowns of AP Environmental Science free response questions and do a great job of showing their work. So check those out if you're looking for a look over my shoulder approach to answering FRQs. We also recommend you create an environmental science formula sheet that you frequently reference back to and internalize throughout the course of your studying. We went over the rule of 70 and the population growth rate formulas earlier in this video, so you can rewind those if you want to start, but there's also some other important formulas that you're going to want to remember. These include formulas related to productivity, population density, and birth and death rates. We link to a Google document in the accompanying blog post if you're looking for some more formulas to internalize. There you have it, 15 environmental science study tips to help you score that 4 or 5 on your APES exam. If you're looking for even more study tips, be sure to check out the accompanying blog article in the link in the video description below. If you found this video helpful, do us a favor and smash that like button below. Also, share it with any friend that you might know that's also taking this exam. If you haven't already, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell for more AP review content like this. Lastly, create your free account on Albert to start leveling up your AP environmental science practice today. When you upgrade, we provide hundreds of practice questions with detailed explanations as well as full-length practice tests to help you prepare for your exam. If you're a teacher that happens to be watching this video, you can also check out our pilot program. With it, you'll be able to try Albert for free with your school for 30 days. That's it for this time though. If you're still in the video mood, check out these videos that YouTube thinks you might like.